In the world today, there is something known as the shidduch crisis. Young people are finding it very, very difficult to find appropriate marriage partners. What is the reason for this? In fact, marriage in general is on the decline. Less and less people are opting to get married and are just cohabiting, living together. But this is the problem that's also spread to the Jewish community. So let's try to understand it. And I think that one of the main reasons has to be with what people are looking for in a marriage partner. They have very unrealistic expectations. I once met an elderly lady who had grown up in Poland, and she said to me that in Poland they used to have somewhat of a humorous saying when it came to looking in particular for a wife. You had to look for three things, and this was based on Yiddish words. The first thing was mezumanim, which means money. The second was mechutanim, which means good in-laws, family. And the third was shena ponim, which means a nice-looking face. Those are the things that people were looking for. Does the young lady have money? Does she come from a good family? And is she good-looking? And although that was humorous, there is certainly a ring of truth in that this is what people are looking for. And these are not always the best attributes when it comes to marriage. In this week's parasha, Chayei Sarah, most of the parasha concentrates on the search of Eliezer, the servant of Avraham, to find a wife for Yitzchak, the son of his master, Avraham. And the story goes that Avraham came to Eliezer and he said, look, Yitzchak is getting older. We need to find for him a wife. He cannot leave the land of Israel because he had the elevated status of what the sages called an Ola Tamima. He was brought upon the altar. He was like a sacrifice. And just as a sacrifice cannot leave the precincts of the temple, so Yitzchak could not leave Eretz Israel. So he couldn't go personally. Eliezer went on his behalf, and he was told by Avraham to go back to his family in Mesopotamia, which he did. And he took with him a number of camels and, of course, a great deal of wealth so that it would be an attractive proposition. And there Eliezer arrives, and he comes to the well outside the city. And he prays to God, and he seems to make a deal with God. And he says, God, give me success. Let me find the right young lady for my master's son. And this is what I'm going to look for. I see all of the young ladies of the city are coming to draw water from the well. If I say to one of those young ladies, please fetch me water, and she goes and she fetches water, and she fetches water not just for me, but for all of my men and all of the camels, then I will know that that is the right girl, the right lady for Yitzchak. And the Talmud queries what Eliezer did there. Is this nichush? Is this relying on omens? That he's worked out this whole methodology. When this lady comes and I say to her X and she answers me Y, then I know that's the right way. Well, the person is not allowed to rely on omens, nichush. How could Eliezer do this? And the commentators say that this was not an omen. This was pure logic. What Eliezer was looking for was chesed, was kindness. He wanted to see if there was a young lady who lived here who was kind, who would do things altruistically. Yes, he would ask her, please, I need some water. I'm thirsty. I'm parched. I've been traveling a long way. But if she of her own accord would offer to give water to all of the people that were accompanying him and all of the camels of her own accord, then he would know this is a person of chesed. And lo and behold, Rivka came out and he said to her, I'm thirsty. Please give me to drink. And she gave him to drink. And of her own accord, and she was a young girl, she took off the special barrel she was holding on her shoulder, and she filled up she filled it up from the water of the well, and she poured it into the troughs, and all of the camels were able to drink. And at that moment, Eliezer knew he had been successful. And before he even asked her name or the family that she came from, he knew that this was the right person. And so it turned out that Rivka was indeed a relative of Avraham and Yitzchak. The main point that he looked for was chesed, was kindness. This was, if you like, the first arranged Jewish marriage. Avraham and Sarah had got married many, many years before they had come into the covenant of God. But Yitzhak and Rivka were the first Jewish marriage. And indeed, the only thing that Eliezer and Avraham were looking for was chesed, was kindness. And indeed, the Talmud tells us that one of the three identifying marks of a Jew is gomlei chasadim, is the ability to do kindness. That's really what marriage is all about. It's very interesting that when a young girl is born or when a boy is brisked, that the message, the blessing that we give to the young infant is that they should be raised to Torah, chuppah, and ma'asim tovim, to study Torah, to go to the wedding canopy, and to do good deeds. Well, the question, of course, is why do we mention good deeds right at the end? We should say that they should study Torah, do good deeds, and get married. You can do good deeds before you're married. Of course you can. They're not dependent one on another. But perhaps what this blessing is emphasizing is that in that partnership of marriage, the main thing that's going to glue it together is kindness, is good deeds one to another. So yes, it's wonderful to have mizumanim, a lot of cash in the account. And it's wonderful to have michutanim, good in-laws. And in the case of Rivka, they weren't such great in-laws. And it's wonderful to have shein upon him, a very beautiful face. But the most important thing, and the thing that Avram looked for, was chesed, was kindness. And if one has kindness, one will be able to overcome all obstacles of marriage. I wish you a Shabbat Shalom.